They said he had been howling and crying before turning red and convulsing.
Of my misery, I have no voice, I have no choice. I'm in your hands, they slowly torture me. Unfreeze your heart, unlock your mind. Another way is yours to find. Will no one hear, will no one see what I endure? Will no one call my name? I'll not know love, I'll not know kind, I'll not know home, will my death be in vain? Tests on me will not help man reveal the truth, the scientific proof.
Point of view. So those dogs are driven mad even before they go to the laboratory. Now the pharmaceutical industry, by law, has to test drugs on a rodent and a non-rodent species. The rodent species is usually a rat. The non-rodent species can be either a dog, a pig, or a monkey. The reason they choose the dog is not for scientific reasons, it's for convenience. You try and shove a tube down the throat of a monkey or a pig with no anesthetic and no pain pills. Only a beagle will allow you to do that. That is the reason the pharmaceutical industry use beagles. There's a huge world of difference between dogs, how dogs and monkeys respond to drugs, and how dogs, monkeys and people respond to drugs. So the strategy in the UK, because of the system, because of the establishment, because of the oppression.
The Member of Parliament for Brighton Pavilion can't be here. She sits, she's the Vice Chair of Parliament, All Party Group and Animal Welfare, and she's also Vice President of the Royal Society for the Protection of Cruelty to Animals. I'll read out a statement that she's prepared for you today. I'm sorry that existing commitments around International Women's Day have prevented me from being with you today. But I'm grateful for the opportunity to send a strong message of support for the work that you're doing at Save the Harlan Beagles. Animal tests are outdated, cruel and inefficient, yet the number of animals being used in UK research is actually increasing, despite a pledge by the coalition government to reduce it. The majority of drugs deemed successful after testing in animals go on to fail in clinical trials, either because they don't produce the same therapeutic effects in people, or because they are too toxic to use on human patients. New technologies are emerging all the time, which are transforming our understanding of human biology. And there is now a global movement amongst the regulatory agencies to replace animal testing with modern technologies.
Save the Harlan Beagles and its substantial and growing following is now acknowledged by other parliamentary figures. And as such, on Wednesday, we've been invited to attend a meeting at Westminster with Nick Dakin, the chair of the All-Party Committee for Replacement of Animals in Medical Experiments. In our discussion, we'll bid for an immediate closure of Harlan and an escalated abandonment of all vivisection. Importantly, we're going to make it clear that whilst we are anti-vivisection, we are not anti-science, something which was assumed in the past by the establishment. We are pro-animal welfare and we are pro-modern science. In the 21st century, the argument for stopping animal experiments is now pro-science and humane. Every day, more scientists speak out against using animal experiments for medical research. It doesn't work, and crucially, they admit it is delaying modern medical breakthroughs. On Wednesday, when we meet with the MP at Westminster, we're going to take this message. And this is your message, because our supporters and the thousands of those who have signed our petition, which now totals 42,000. Without your support, meetings like this in Parliament would not be possible.